Hi everyone, welcome back to Classgo Education online YouTube learning channel. This is Gaurav. So today I am taking another numerical from block reduction technique, one of the most important numerical of block reduction technique, as it consists of all the block reduction technique rules. Okay, so it is one of the toughest and one of the most important numerical. Once you get through this numerical, you will have a better insight how to solve other numericals related to block reduction techniques. So in this numerical, just you have to see that it is a pictorial representation where blocks are connected and where you will see the signal flow. In this particular numerical, one thing which we have to address, that we are having three summing points, S1, S2 and S3, okay? And simultaneously you just see we are having two takeoff points, X2 and X1. Okay, so we have to just replace or swap the positions of these summing points or takeoff point, and there would be some modification going on with the takeoff point branch or the summing point branch. We will see all such rules and we will try to incorporate such rules, and we will try to channelize how to solve such block reduction technique numericals. So before starting this numerical, take a pause, try to analyze this numerical, try to solve this numerical by your own. If you are not able to solve this numerical, then look after the solution. Okay, so in the meanwhile, I am providing you the solution. So the first step would be a very easy step, that you have to put the X2 takeoff point, which is placed right now after the G2. We have to place this takeoff point X2 before the block G2. First step is this. Okay, now before analyzing this particular step, we have to address one thing, very important address, that you just see, once a signal will flow in this direction, what will happen at X2? Signal will comprises of G2. At X2 point, signal will automatically comprises of this block gain, that is G2. Okay, but when we are replacing this X2 before the block G2, the demarcation, or you can say, now X2 will not have that G2 signal. To compensate that G2 signal, this H2 will be multiplied by G2. So in step 1, X2 is replaced, which is placed right now after the block, it would be placed before the block G2, and to compensate G2, H2 would be multiplied by G2. So in this particular step 1, this thing certainly happened. Over here you just see that we have placed the position of X2, okay? Here you just see we have changed the position of X2, and you just see that G2 is multiplied by S2. So compensation took place automatically. So it's very easy to understand. Now in the step 2, what we will do? We will just replace this X2 block, which is placed after the summing point S2. Okay, this X2. So we have to do that, we will place this X2 takeoff point after, or right now it is placed after the summing point S2. We will place this X2 before the summing point S2. Okay, we will place this X2 before the summing point S2. Now whenever such thing happen, automatically a summing point is introduced, which will compensate the signal flow. What I did in previous step, same thing happens. If you have just properly understood the block reduction technique rules, whenever a takeoff point is placed after the summing point, okay, and if you have to place that takeoff point before the summing point, there would be addition of a summation block, and this thing happened in this numerical as well. So in this numerical you just see that a summing point S4 is incorporated. A summing point S4 is incorporated. Now you just see there are three summing points in the previous stage, but right now we are having four summing points, S1, S2, S3 and S4. Okay, so we have to arrange these summing points in such a way so that this block reduction technique numerical can be easily understood. Okay, so in the next step, what we did, we are just going to do that we are placing this S2 summing point after the block G2. Okay, we are placing this एस टू समिंग पॉइंट आफ्टर द ब्लॉक जी टू. अगेन टेक अ पॉज एंड ट्राई टू एनालाइज इफ एस टू इज प्लेस्ड आफ्टर द ब्लॉक जी टू वॉट विल हैपन. देर विल बी अ सिग्नल फ्लो. टू कंपनसेट दैट सिग्नल फ्लो वी हैव टू इनकॉर्पोरेट सम ब्लॉक बिटवीन द पाथ एंड दैट टू हैपेंड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर स्टेप. सो यू जस्ट सी वेन वी आर डूइंग दिस थिंग अ जी टू ब्लॉक गेन इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड. अ जी टू ब्लॉक गेन इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड टू कंपनसेट द सिग्नल फ्लो एंड दिस एक्चुअली हैपेंड ओवर यू. सो दिस इज बेसिकली द पोजिशन वेयर एस टू इज रिप्लेस्ड ओके आफ्टर द ब्लॉक जी टू. नाउ वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट रूल वेन एवर वी आर हैविंग टू समिंग पॉइंट्स एडजेसेंट टू ईच अदर we can replace those two summing points. Right now you just see that S2 and S3 are placed at adjacent position and there is as such no takeoff point between them. There is as such no gain between them. So there is as such no constraint. So we can replace the position of S2 and S3. S3 will take the position of S2 and S2 will take the position of S3. So in the further step, S2 and S3 would be replaced. So in the further step, we will just replace S2 over here. So in the step number 4, this thing happened. S2 is replaced over here. Okay. So you just see, S2 is replaced over here. And S3 is placed over here. This actually is the demand of this numerical, because now you just see that G2 and G3 would be arranged in parallel and they can easily be added. So G2 plus G3, this particular block completely we reduced to G2 plus G3, and this particular block can easily be understood as a feedback signal. Okay, so on reducing these two blocks, we will be seeing a very easy layout. That is basically this thing. You can see that G2 plus G3 is added and G2 H1 are just having a product and they are providing a feedback. So further, this particular numerical can be reduced in such a way that the signal flow can be easily understood. Okay, so this is very important. So G2 and G3 are added. Okay, remember G2 and G3 are added and G2 is multiplied by H1 providing a feedback, and right now you just see that H1 is flowing is in this direction, so H1 will come automatically over here also. Okay, so this is the reduced diagram. So you just see in this H1 came over here also and G2 and H1 came over here. Further, this particular numerical can be easily understood because this particular section G2 plus G3 and G2 H1, this will form a cascade in series. So the reduced block diagram would be like this, whereby you just see the cascades are multiplied to each other. Okay, and in the last step, step number 7, again a very simple logistic we will use. We will try to analyze, we will further follow this particular step whereby we are just putting this particular position of S4 which would be placed right now over here. Okay, and when we are doing this thing, the block can be reduced further. This is the way you can see the reduced block, and there is a very small difference you will find because H1 is providing a signal over here. So H1 will get multiplied with the G2 S2. Okay, so with this modification we can easily analyze this numerical, and now after modification takes place, S4 and S1 and complete block would be in cascade. This would be the forward gain, this would be the feedback gain, this would be the negative, this would be the positive signal, positive feedback signal right now, because signal you just see that positive end is coming over here. So this is the basically concept, and further the answer, the solution which we are getting of this particular block reduction numerical is when we have to address this thing. Okay, so this is the solution, and a very important numerical it is. Take care of this numerical, and we will try to analyze this numerical, and we will get same solution with the signal flow graph with very easy steps. But to understand block reduction technique, these particular steps need to be addressed. That is basically the swapping of summing points, replacing the summing points, or you can say putting the takeoff point before the summing point. What are the signal flow modification takes place? So all these steps need to be addressed. If you want the PDF of this particular video, let me know. Just go through my about and about me, and there you will get my email ID. From there you can just mail me whatever the queries you are having. Thanks for watching. Let me know any other numerical related to block reduction technique which you are not able to solve. Please let me know through mail or write a comment and try to provide us the snapshot of the numerical. We will try to make another video covering such numericals as well. So thank you for watching. Stay tuned. Have a good day.